Monica Kaufman Pearson. I cannot believe we've come full circle.
This is so exciting, Karyn. Finally, we're going to get to work together. I've always called you my little sister, and we belong to the same sorority, and we've always been good friends, and now we're going to be co-workers.
I love it. I remember you retiring. I cannot believe how long it's been.
It has been 9 years this year.
What have you done in these 9 years?
Well, in 9 years, I went back to school and got my master's degree from the University of Georgia, from Grady School of Journalism and Communication. I taught for a year. I did radio, had a radio show, and then I started doing commercials. And it was like this opportunity came along, and I was like, yes! I love doing interviews, just like you. I love getting into everybody's business and asking those questions your mother told you never to ask, to get to really know people in a way that viewers don't get to know them. And so personality interviews have always been the thing that I love to do.
And you've always been so amazing at them. You are Atlanta's Barbara Walters, I always say. Atlanta's Oprah, because you get the best out of people.
And isn't it interesting that I've interviewed both of them?
Yes.
And got tips from them too, and got things out of them that other people hadn't. That's what I like to do, is to get people comfortable enough that they will tell me things that they don't normally share. So you see that human side of them versus that television side of them.
Okay, let me try my Monica, Barbara, Oprah. A story that I love that you tell is about how we almost didn't have you here in Atlanta.
What's so funny is I was working at a station in Louisville, Kentucky. Well, actually, let's go back to the beginning. I was working at the newspaper and wanted to get a job in television. So I applied for a job at WAVE. And the news director told me I would never get a job in television because I didn't look the part. I wrote like a newspaper reporter. And, you know, the best thing for me to do was just to stay in newspaper. The hilarious part about this is that Diane Sawyer was a weather girl in Louisville, Kentucky at that time because she couldn't get a job as a reporter. Full circle moment. The station that told me I would never make it in television is now part of Gray Television. And now I'm part of Gray Television. God has a sense of humor.
He really does. He really does. And we laugh about Oprah Winfrey. There's an Oprah Winfrey story as well.
Well, there were three people who were up for the job at my previous station, Jane Pauley, Oprah Winfrey, and me. And I got the job. I say it's because I was the cheapest one. But for years, before Oprah really became as big as she is now, she would look at me and say, "You got my job." And I would think, "Oh, really?"
We've got you. We love that we've got you. And you've missed this. You've also been doing a fun kind of interview program. Kind of the View meets...
Oh, it's the thing I love about what we called A Seat at the Table, but coming here, it will have a new name, just like my personality interview show will have a new name. Three women, three black women, three different generations, talking honestly, honestly about how we feel, how we're treated, and issues that concern us. We've done shows on... do you really need to go to college? We've looked at race and DNA and what does it really mean. We've looked at sisterhood in the sense of, can white women and black women truly be friends, and what things do we have in common and what things separate us? What's different about this show is because we're all from different backgrounds and we're all different ages and we're all at a different place in our lives. So I would say it's not a show for the faint at heart, because we do tell it like it is. But what's been interesting is that I find white women like it, because all of a sudden there's a window opened and they go, "I didn't know I was insulting someone by acting that way," or, "You know, I didn't know I should do that," or, "Gee, I have a black friend, but is she really a friend? Do I invite her to dinner? Do I describe her by color and not by our interests? So it's going to be fun to see these two shows that I love, Personality Interviews and Three Black Women Telling It Like It Is.
Now, Monica, you just didn't want to stay in retirement and relax and knit and, you know, do all that fun stuff?
Well, I never learned to knit, but I do crochet. I don't call retirement retirement. I have always called it rewirement. And even though I was doing things that I like to do, from radio and commercials, this was an opportunity, Karyn, that I could not pass up. Because it's working for a station that is really a family in itself. And when I met Hilton Howell, I fell in love with him. His openness, his friendliness, but his good business sense, and his desire to make this station number one in the market. And some people may say, oh, that's a long haul. Well, he's in it for the long haul. And that's important to me. It was hard leaving my past, but I see this as a new beginning. And I just look forward to be able to use my skills here to make it better. But most importantly, I am just so happy to be working with you and doing the things I love to do, which is getting into everybody's business.
Now, many people have tried to steal you away from your old place. Even the first general managers here. You were not ready to do it until now.
No, not until now. I think I needed that separation. I needed that 9 years to really sit back and find out who I was and what I really wanted to do. Doing the news is one thing, and I did it for 37 years and loved it. And I'm a former newspaper reporter, too. But I love being able to give and take with the people I interview. I love not having to sit there and make sure that I don't get out of frame. Now, I do love politics.
And we've got a nice year coming ahead of
us, don't we? We got a governor's race coming up, and then we have a presidential race coming up. So,
Senate race is coming up?
It's like, But really, I could sit at home, but I wouldn't be happy. And as my husband says all the time, you know, the Bible says it is better to go live in the corner of the roof of the house than to live with a woman who's not happy.
I missed that one.
But no, this was such an opportunity. I had to come here to do what I think I do best. I know some people are going to be disappointed, but you know what I've learned at this point in my life? For years, I've made it about everybody else. Now it's time to do for me and not feel guilty about it.
Any hint on who some of those first interviews could be?
Oh, no. You've got to tune in to find out.
Do you have a time yet or a date?
Well, I know we'll put the first interview on in February, but we don't have a date yet, and that is Black History Month.
So that's a hint.
That's a hint.
I love that. I love that. Well, you have touched so many hearts, and I just need to say, from the first time I met you when I moved here more than 30 years ago, you reached out, welcomed me to Atlanta, let's have lunch. That's who you are. Now you're going to be able to continue to inspire the young people who come here and to all our other gray stations, which is amazing.
Well, that's the one thing I told Hilton, that I want to be here doing the shows, but what I really love is mentoring younger reporters. I actually have a young woman who works at a gray station in Albany, Georgia, Albany, and I am working with her, helping her get better. I like working with young people, teaching them how to really make their interviewing better, how to write tighter, how to produce. And in this day of MMJs, how to shoot a story so it looks like you had a photographer on the other side, how you can still do that stand-up. And so I guess it's something that happens where you go, I have all this knowledge, and I don't want to take it to the grave. I want to leave it. I want to share it. It was a gift to me, and what do you do with the gift? You give it away because it is a present.
That's right. I mean, it was called something else when we did it. We were MMJs in the
beginning. Oh, yeah. It's called One Man Band.
Yes, it was. So they think we don't know what we're talking about, but we do.
We do.
Oh, Monica, we are so excited to have you here. As you saw when you came, you were brought to tears.
Yes, and I don't cry easily. You know, I hate to say this, I didn't even cry at my mother's funeral, and you all had me in tears because I didn't expect to be welcomed that way. And it meant so much to me. So I am hoping that I can return that love that was given to me when I walked through that door and that support that was given to me when I walked through that door. I hope I can return it to everybody here at WGCL.
Were you worried? Were you really worried about walking in these doors?
Yeah, I was really worried about it. I was worried for two reasons. You know, when you've been the competition, you don't know who's going to like you. You don't know whether people wonder, are you coming in to take their jobs? You know, I was very nervous. How would I be received? But I'm just as nervous about going back to my other station where I have to do commercials, because I know there are people who are upset and who are really hurt by the decision that I made. But again, it's time for me. It's time for me, and I don't feel guilty about that anymore.
Did it make you cry trying to make this decision?
Oh, no, not at all. I didn't have a problem with making the decision. I felt I had to make courtesy calls to let people know because I cared about those people. And they were disappointed. But again, I did the right thing. I let them know. And some viewers aren't going to be happy with me, but I hope they will give me and you and all the staff here a chance. Just turn over and see us. Give us a chance. Because I wouldn't be here if I didn't believe in the quality of work and the integrity of the people who work here. I wouldn't be here.
Let's be honest. This has been a hard station to get numbers.
Mm-hmm.
This has been a hard station for people to watch. Your star power, your journalistic excellence, your just being warm and inviting to everyone is something that is sure to change that for the station.
I hope so, but all of that you're saying about me, I can say about you. It's just the point of getting the eyes here. And so we've got to look at ways to make sure that our viewers give us a chance. The investigative work you all do here is excellent. The problem is oftentimes the work that is done here is then picked up by somebody else and it becomes their breaking news story or their investigation. And I think, you know, you're the little train, we're the little train that can. And I fully believe, as Hilton does and as you do, as Eric does, that it's not just, I think I can, I think I can. I think now it's, I know I can, I know I can. And in any way I can help to do that, I'm here.
Well, we're ready for you. Thanks, Big
Some
Sis.
Good things are happening in 2022 and 2023. And I am happy to be here to help shine a light on it and get viewers here. Because once they see the work we do, they're going to stay.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And you expected some of that work to be on WGCL as well as Peachtree TV.
I don't know where they're going to put me. I know that the new version of A Seat at the Table and the new version of a Monica Kaufman's Close-Ups will be on Peachtree TV.
Might you anchor some more?
Not while I am doing commercials. But who knows when those contracts end up. But I think your anchor team is superb. You don't need any more anchors. You don't need
you
any more
need
anchors.
Need backup anchors.
Yeah, backup is fine. I don't mind being anybody's backup. Okay. But I'm not here to do anybody else's job. Let me be very plain about that. I don't want to do the new news unless it's vacation relief. I don't want to do the evening news unless it's vacation relief. You have excellent talent here. So, you know, vacation relief, but every day, I'm too old for that.
No, you're not. Thank you, girl. No, you're not.
Love you, Karyn.
I love you. So glad you're here.
It's a new me. It's a new day. And I can't wait to contribute.
Man, you've done a lot at 50.
Girl, I got shoes older than 50. But I don't mind telling my age, because age ain't nothing but a number, as my mother said. And my number is not unlisted. I am 74 years old, and I know I don't look it, and I don't act it, and I don't think that way. And anybody who thinks you can't teach an old dog new trick, look at me.
I met you. Thanks, Moni.
Thank you, my sweet Karyn.
I'm telling you, she's a hoot.